Hello, this is Michael Albers from Germany. Excuse my bad English, and I want to show you an Animate CC tutorial about drag and drop with Canvas HTML5. I have a movie clip, this one here. I can drag it, and if this movie clip touches the other movie clip, the destination movie clip, you see it will get transparent. And when I put up the mouse and it touches the other movie clip, it will be in the center of this movie clip. This is a drag object, this is a destination object. And I want to show you how to program this thing with JavaScript. First, you have to know what is get bounds and get transform bounds. Take a look at this block. There it is explained by Brent Skinner. The method get bounds and get transformed bound will get a rectangle object. I will show you one example. Here's a movie clip. The movie clip has an instance name MyMC. Now I'm inside this movie clip, in the local coordinate system of this movie clip. And here is a bitmap object. You can see the position of the bitmap object, and you can see the width and the height of the bitmap object. And this rectangle, you can see here, that is MyMC get bounds. Also the rectangle inside the local coordinate systems. If I have more objects here, more bitmaps, the width will be bigger and the height will be this one from there to there. Now, all the children object which deliver get bounds, there will be a rectangle around them, and this is a get bounds rectangle. So, when I have this action script, I will get the rectangle inside the local coordinate system. Now I will get this x position, y position, width, and height. Transform bounds is a rectangle in the parent object. Now this movie clip is here in the main stage, and the main stage is the parent object of this. And get transform bounds will get me this rectangle, this xy position. I put this on 0, 0. It's not the position of the nominal, it's the position here of the content. And it has still this width, 304, and this height, 199. And if I transform this, maybe I make this 200, and the height I make to 100. And I put this on the upper left corner. This will be get transform bounds. So now let's take a look into the script. Here I make get transform bounds. And with console.log, this rectangle will be shown. If I test this, we can see the x and y value and the width and the height of this object from the parent object in the local coordinate system of the parent object. If you have a movie clip with a bitmap inside, this gives me get bounds. If you have a movie clip And inside the movie clips there is no bitmap, there is only a shape. Ne? I have here two instances of the movie clip box. This is a movie clip box. Now I'm inside the local coordinate system of the box. And here inside this box is a shape. And shapes don't give me get bounds. So what can I do? I make set bounds. Here I'm on the stage and I have here a box 1 and here a box 2. The two instances of this movie clip. Now I make set bounds, and with set bounds I put a rectangle of this shape object, and then I can use get transformed bounds to get the rectangle from the parent element. And with these two rectangles, I can ask if they intersect themselves. This rectangle method intersects gives me true or false. If they intersect, the both rectangles, also my bounds 1 and my bounds 2 from box 1 and from box 2, this gives me true. Otherwise, it gives me false. So let's take a look. Yeah, they intersect, and so I have true. So that is important we need for our drag and drop example. Now I show you a simple drag and drop example. I have two movie clips. This one is called Rot, and this one as the instance name Grün. And here is the script. Both have an event listener, press move. This means when I press down the mouse button and move the thing around, no? Drag the thing around. And this is a drag me function I've made. At first I will put this display object on top of all the other display objects with agile. And then I have a variable point, and a point object has always a x coordinate and a y coordinate. This event stage x and event stage y is the mouse position, but from the view of the browser window, not from the view of the canvas element. This is a different thing. So I have to put this mouse position to the local coordinate system of the canvas, and I make this with global to local. So I get the mouse position inside the canvas element, and I put the current target, or the red or the green movie clip, to this mouse position, as you can see here. So I can drag it around. So now we have all we need for our example. This is my example. There's only script. There's nothing on the stage. In the library, I have two movie clips, and inside the movie clips, there is a bitmap. Here is this bitmap, and in this movie clip is this bitmap. They have linkage names. You can double click here and put the linkage name. And with this linkage name, you can make an instance to the stage. Let's take a look at the script. At first, I'm making a new instance of this Rad called Dragger. I position this Dragger on the stage. Then I make a new instance of the other movie clip, linkage name Steel. And I position it. In the end of the script, I put both objects to the display list, stage, agile, destination, and dragger. So now I have to move the dragger around. I make this with press move, with a nameless function here. And here in this press move function, you can see I have my variable p, and I put the mouse position in the local coordinate system of the canvas element. And then I put my object to this mouse position. Stage update you don't need if you make this in the frame. Then I have an if structure, if else, and in this if structure I call an intersect function. It's a function I've made by myself, and this intersect function gives me true or false if they both objects intersect. He needs two objects, the dragger object and the destination object I've put here. And it gives me true if they intersect, and the event current target will be half transparent if they intersect, otherwise it will not be transparent. So if I check this out, it will look like this. If I move it around and they intersect, this is half transparent, otherwise it is not transparent. So take a look on this intersect function I've made. In this function, I have these two objects and I get the rectangle from the parent coordinate system here from both objects. Then I have an if structure, and in this if structure, I asked if both rectangles intersect. This intersects function, it's called intersects, not intersect, is a function from the rectangle object which gives me true if they intersect or false if not. So my intersect function will give me true if they intersect or false if they not intersect. I made this function because I need it two times. I need it here on the press move function and I need it here on the press up function. So here I have my press up function. Again, I ask if they intersect, and if that is the case, I position the trigger in the middle of the destination object. Again, I ask the get transformed bounds, the rectangle from the parent object, and then I position this trigger object in the middle. It is the x position plus half the width. Now the x position is the left side plus half the width is the middle of the object, and the same with the y position. Trigger alpha is 1, so it is not transparent. That's all. Now that's all we need. So I show you the script again. This is the first script, the first part of the script. And this is the second part of the script. And here's the rest. I can make this a little bit bigger. So good luck with it. Give me a thumbs up if you like it. You're Michael Alves from www.pastorpixel.de.